Bahumana Petta Rajya Sabha Deputy Chairman Sri PJ Kurian, Reverend Dr. Philippus Marco Chrysostom Marthoma Varia Metropolitan Tirumeni, Reverend Dr. Joseph Marthoma Metropolitan Tirumeni, Bahumana Petta Kerala Til Mun Mukhyamantri Sri Vaman Chandi, Jala Vibhava Vakup Mantri Sri Matthew T. Thomas, Lok Sabha Angam Sri Anto Antony, Most Reverend Dr. Thomas Mar Corellis Tirumani, Most Reverend Yohanan Mar Christmas Metropolitan Niram Diocese Tirumani, Malankara Orthodox Syrian Church, Most Reverend Joseph Mar Gregorius Metropolitan Tirumani, Saint Secretary Malankara Jacobite Syria Church, Respected Dr. G. Varghese Mar Theodos Episcopa Tirumani, Reverend K. G. Joseph Sabha Secretary, Sri Raju Abraham MLA, and the other public representatives who are all present here. Ellavarkkum enrai namaskaram. Devatinrai Swantam Nataya, Harita Keralatil, Uruvan Eneki Atiaya Santoshamundu. E Danya Muhurtitil, Philippos Mar Christostom, Varia Tirumanikum, Dr. Joseph Marthoma Tirumanikum, Enrai Hrudayam Niranya Asamsakal. Bahumana Patta Rajya Sabha Deputy Chairman, Professor P.J. Kuriyande Kshana Prakaram, Ivide Uruvan. It's all because of my colleague and my deputy in Rajya Sabha, Sri P.J. Kurian, that I could come here and have this occasion to meet you, greet you, talk to you, and also stay with the bishop, and also have lunch with other colleagues, and also have the advice of the great saint who has been recognized by the government of India through Padma Bhushan, Dr. Philippos Marco Chrysostomo Marthoma Varia Metropolitan Tirumani. I really feel happy because earlier as a politician, I used to go here and there to different communities, different religions, used to meet them. But now I am no more in politics. I am retired from politics, but not tired from public life. That's why I'm here. Friends, this is a great occasion. And it gives me great joy to visit this state, Kerala, the evergreen state of Republic of India, what we fondly call the God's own country, a state of which we are proud because of the enduring, enterprising spirit. It's a unique state in India which has a literacy rate of 94%, the highest in the country, the highest human development index among all the states, and the highest life expectancy, and the highest sex ratio. It is a state which has traditionally welcomed all religions over the last 20 centuries, and is the land of Adi Shankara, the greatest exponent of Advaita philosophy, the land of Charaman Juma Masjid at Kodangallur, the very first mosque in India. It is the land of Thomas, the apostle who walked this land in the 6th century AD. It is the land where the Hindu rulers like Sanu Ravi Varma of Venad gifted a plot of land in the 9th century AD to build a church. It is the land where Judaism, Jainism, Buddhism coexisted over so many centuries. No wonder it is called God's own country, where divinity has been worshipped in multiple forms by different sects, exemplifying the ancient Indian vision of welcoming noble ideas and ideals from across the globe. My friends, we all know the universal truth is one, even though wise men express it in different forms. It is a matter of great pride that we have this illustrious cultural heritage in our country, Ours is a country that has celebrated plurality, diversity, and inclusivity. We must collectively strengthen this unique perspective. Today, we are celebrating the 101st birthday of His Grace, Most Revered Philippos Mark Chrysostomos Mar Thoma Varia Metropolitan, and the 60th anniversary of priestly ordination of His Grace, Most Reverend Dr. Joseph Mar Thoma Metropolitan. Why this felicitation? The felicitation is to give inspiration to others to work like them. That is the idea behind the felicitation. One must observe the way they lived, and they loved the people, worked for the people, conducted themselves. That should be a guidance to the new generation. That's why normally our Indian tradition, our culture, our heritage is we felicitate people who have done something good in their respective fields. So these two great sons of this great country, sons of God, they have lived in an exemplary manner, living 100 years without blemish, with active life, is not an ordinary achievement itself. It itself is a great achievement. And it's really God's blessing that he has been there to serve the society in different capacities all these years. And I was just telling my friend Mr. Kurian that will be coming here to the 100th birth anniversary of Dr. Joseph Mar Thoma Metropolitan also, if at all we are alive till such time. Because I wish that as per the tradition of India, the culture of India is we always felicitate people who does something good to the society. I am aware that Mar Thoma Church is an ancient church founded by Saint Thomas, one of the apostles of Jesus Christ. It is also a national church with the deep roots in the history of independent India. The church always stood for freedom and justice. Late C. T.M. Varghese was among those trio who fought against the British in restoring Travancore state, along with the late Sri Keshavan and late Sri Pattam A. Thanupille. I am also aware when emergency was declared, it was the head of the church who wrote to the then Prime Minister protesting against emergency and suggesting that should be withdrawn at the earliest. Thus, the church always stood for freedom and liberty. I am also happy that this ancient church was gifted to our nation several leaders of eminence and great statures like Dr. M.M. Thomas, former Governor of Nagaland, Justice K.T. Thomas, former Supreme Court Judge, freedom fighter late Sri T.M. Varghese, and my colleague Professor P.J. Kurian, the Deputy Chairman of Rajya Sabha. It gives me immense joy to be with the people of Kerala on this very happy occasion, celebrating two important landmarks in the lives of two illustrious sons of our great country, Padma Bhushan, Dr. Philippos Mar Chrysostomos Varia Metropolitan Thirumeni, and His Grace, the Most Reverend Dr. Joseph Mar Thoma Metropolitan Thirumeni. I congratulate Reverend Dr. Philippos Mark Krasthama, who has completed 100 years of active service to God and God's devotees. I applaud his achievements and appreciate his contribution for the well-being of the people of our nation. I am reminded of the prayer in Atharvana Veda, which says, I quote, "Let us live for 100 years and beyond with good health, intelligence, and ever widening thoughts. His grace, the great Thirumeni, is truly blessed that he has been given this vast and unique opportunity to serve humanity for so many decades. We are blessed to be in his presence today. Many of you are well aware, Dr. Reverend Dr. Philippos Mar Thomas Varia Metropolitan Thirumeni has endeared himself to his devotees because he showers his blessings through good humor and present demeanor. Reverend Dr. Philippos Mar Chrysostomos Varia Metropolitan Thirumeni, possibly one of the longest living bishops in the world and a devout idealist, believes the way to the Creator is through the creations of the God. He has internalized the essence of Christianity and propagated its tenets through his words and action. when his goodness have completed 90 years, I am happy to note that Marthoma Church through the Navati project reached out to the people in the margins, and more than 2,500 houses were gifted to them. I came to know that Navati celebration was inaugurated by veteran leader Sri R. Krishna Advaniji at that time. He had wished Metropolitan a life of more than 100 years and also assured to attend his 100th birthday. I am happy to know that he came and inaugurated the centenary celebrations last year. I am happy to know that a biographical film has been made on Centurion Metropolitan Emeritus Philippus Marcus, who served as a bishop for nearly 66 years. I am told it itself is a record. Helping the needy and the poor has been his sole mission, continues to be even now. I also congratulate the Metropolitan Dr. Joseph Marthoma, who is celebrating the Diamond Jubilee of his holy ordination. I am happy that the people have benefited from his visionary leadership and enduring passion for the health and well-being of suffering humanity. I am told that he is also champion of the environmental protection. And I also understand that the Great Moromon Convention is instrumental in taking up a large-scale plantation program. It is indeed heartening that as part of Dr. Joseph Marthoma's 80th birthday, the Marthoma Church has initiated a challenging project called Snehakaram, Hand of Love, to give help for the people who suffer from life-threatening diseases like cancer. Dialysis is being given free of cost to the people in need of help and support, with a funding of more than 1 crore rupees annually. This project is undoubtedly a great help and succor to people who suffer financial hardship. I am happy that this help is extended to all people, regardless of caste or creed. That's a noble way of doing things. I congratulate Dr. Joseph Marthoma for his sincere and also ecumenical leadership in national and international arena. I wish him many more years of leadership in the path shown by Dr. Johaman Marthoma and other great leaders of the Marthoma Church. My best wishes are with you, sir, for all the success, and also the best wishes of the Government of India are also there with you. My best wishes are with the people of Kerala, with its rich cultural heritage and wide range of religious traditions. As I mentioned earlier, the state is a pace setter for a nation in many ways. It is fortunate to have an enlightened leadership for a long period. The Maharaj of Travancore's visionary leadership, the reformist zeal of Sri Narayana Guru, the invaluable contribution by the church leaders like Reverend Dr. Philippos Marcus Marthomas Varia, Metropolitan Tirumani, and Reverend Dr. Joseph Marthoma, Metropolitan, as well as other spiritual and cultural leaders, have enriched the cultural capital of India. We are deeply indebted to these visionary leaders who had an underlying belief the service to humanity leads to one towards divinity. Serving the man is serving the God. That is the Indian philosophy. Manava Seva is Madhava Seva. And this church, true to its philosophy and Indian thinking and culture and heritage, is continuing it through its actions of serving the people. It might be worthwhile to remember that what another great exponent of India thought, Swami Vivekananda, had said in the World Parliament of Religious at Chicago on 29 September 1893. I quote, "The seed is put in the ground, and earth and air and water are placed around it. Does the seed become the earth or the air or the water? No, it becomes a plant. It develops after the law of its own growth, assimilates the air, the earth and the water, converts them into plant substance, and grows into a plant. Similar is the case with religion. The Christian is not become a Hindu, or a Hindu not become a Buddhist, or a Buddhist not become a Hindu, not becoming a Buddhist, or becoming a Christian, but each must assimilate the spirit of the others and yet preserve his individuality and grow according to his own law of growth. I'm happy today for the celebrations also. Greatness, the Tirumani has invited this Malankara Jacobite Syrian Church, and also the Theodicies of Episcopa Thirumani and also the Malankara Orthodox Syrian Church. All these people, Malankara Catholic Church, they have all been called together. Because in different ways, in different means, everybody is trying to serve the mankind. Follow the dictations of God. The methods may be different, but our aim, our goal is one and the same. I personally feel that religion is a way of worship. But we all must think in terms of having a culture, a heritage, which is given by our forefathers. Thousands of years of civilization. Indian civilization is one of the oldest civilization. We have seen the Babylonian civilization, the Roman civilization, the Egyptian civilization, the Greek civilization. And we have seen the Indian civilization. Indian civilization is staying strong, stable. Even today, the reason being India, Indian ethos, Indian culture believes in Sarve Jana Sukhino Bhavantu Vasudaiva Kutumbam. The entire universe is one family. That is the philosophy of India. My friends, I would like to tell you one more thing. That India's GDP before the invasion was 27% of the world GDP. And India once upon a time was called as Vishwa Guru. Students from different countries used to come here to Nalanda, to the erstwhile Takshashila, and they used to read and enrich their knowledge. Pahiyan, Huansong, Chinese historians came to India and wrote about the greatness of India. In spite of all this greatness, all this wealth, all this past, India never attacked any country in the world. That is the greatness of Indian culture and Indian heritage. I feel proud of the same. We never believed in attacking anybody. That is the greatness of this land. That is the culture. When I was talking about culture and trying to differentiate between religion and culture, one student asked me, "Sir, explain in better way what is culture." I said, "Religion is a way of worship, culture is a way of living. The way you live." He said, "I am not able to understand properly. Can you simply say it in your own way of putting it in one-liners or two-liners?" I tried my best. He said, "Sir, still I am not satisfied." Then I told him, if you have a roti or a bread, if you eat your bread, that is prakriti, nature. If you snatch the bread of other person and eat yourself, it is vikruti, against the nature. If you have a bread and the other man is suffering with hunger, you give your bread to him or give half of your bread to him, that is called as samskruti, that is the culture of India. That's what I have told. Whether it is a church, whether it is a temple, whether it is a mosque, or masjid, or gurudwara, everybody's aim is emancipation of the mankind, both physically as well as mentally. We must enlighten them. We must educate them. We must show the path of